Hey everyone, and welcome back to the Crypto Analyst channel. My name is Brendan, and I hope all of you guys are having a great day no matter where you are from. And today we're going to be talking about whether a true bottom is in for cryptocurrency, and if we really are seeing a market reversal that could lead us back to all-time highs. Now, we're going to be talking about all the news as well, including one of the largest hacks in crypto history, which seemingly hasn't had a huge effect on the overall price of crypto as a whole. Most cryptos are down about 1% to 2% on the day, and we're going to talk about just a few of the outliers in here as well, but there's a lot of positive news pouring in that we need to talk about, but we're also going to be talking about what's happening over here on the charts of Bitcoin, Ethereum, and the entirety of the altcoin market cap. So if something like this sounds familiar or sounds something that is interesting to you, make sure you stick around and consider subscribing if you like the content at the end of this video, because we put out weekly content like this one. So let's go ahead and talk about what's happening in the crypto market right now. I have a ton of stuff drawn up on my chart, and we also have the MACD and the RSI, which are both in bullish areas right now, as there is a lot of positive sentiment in the market. So first of all, let's talk about this hack that has not had really that much effect on the overall price of crypto, despite it being one of the largest hacks in the history of cryptocurrency. We're talking about Axie Infinity's Ronin hack of nearly $625 million. Now, this is going to be probably its own video, but I want to briefly run over this. And essentially, the way that it works is that Ronin only had 9 validator nodes for their blockchain, for their ecosystem. And what this means is that if someone wanted to take over and kind of had, I guess you could say, free reign with it, all they would need to do is take over 5 of those 9 nodes to have majority power. And it looks like that's exactly what they did. They took over at least 5 of those nodes and started just mass offloading Ethereum. And it was just an absolutely insane hack. Now, why the team behind Axie would only have 9 validator nodes for a blockchain like this is beyond me, but this was massive. But despite this being one of the largest hacks in crypto history, if not the largest hack, cryptocurrency as a whole is still seeing a really nice stabilization. Usually when we see something like this, crypto tends to overreact and price should drastically fall downwards, but I think market sentiment right now is so positive that we're only really seeing about a 1% to 2% drop across the board for most cryptos, and other cryptos are still green on the day. I mean, we have Avalanche that's still up 5%, Terra Luna on an absolutely tear here recently for good reason. We actually have some news about them just a little bit later in the video, but I mean, Bitcoin's only down about 1%. Ethereum's only down about 1% as well. But the crypto markets are holding really, really well. Solana's another one up 11% on the day, 28% on the week. But cryptocurrency, usually when it sees this kind of news that happens in Bitcoin, you tend to think that it's going to cause a sellout. Now, let's talk about these levels. We have been talking about this and calling for this for a while now, right? We broke resistance, former support, now turn resistance. We've been talking about this on Crypt Nation for a while. And as soon as we broke out of this, look, we went straight past this resistance level and actually broke all the way up to about 48.25 before seeing a little bit of resistance and rejection. Now, what I'm expecting here is hopefully and ideally a little bit of a pullback, maybe like a break, hook, and go, so we can break back up, hook, and then continue to the upside. But I do think that this could very well be the bottom for cryptocurrency. I mean, this really does just look like a beautiful W formation, and that is usually a sign of a bottom and a reversal. Now, beyond that, I think we have a separate video talking about how this was a 53% retracement on Bitcoin. And hopefully I'm not moving too fast for everyone. If I am, let me know in the comment section down below and we'll slow it down for the next video. But this was a near 53, and I don't even have this measured out all the way, but this was about a near 53% retracement from the top of our swing over here over to the bottom. And what this means and why this is significant is because for the past 4 market cycles, 3 excluding this one, This is exactly where we've retraced to. We've retraced about 53% of the way down from swing high to swing low, meaning from death cross to reversing back to a golden cross. We have fallen about 53% from our all-time high before bottoming out and continuing in a bullish trend for the past 3 to 4 market cycles, whether you include or exclude this one. Now, that would put us exactly at where we're at right now for Bitcoin. And this could be a sign that the bottom is very well in. I mean, major primary resistance is broken. Bitcoin now has higher swing highs and higher swing lows, and it has broken the downtrend. And guess what? On top of all of this, our 50 EMA is now moving back upwards towards our 200 as if it wants to create a golden cross. So I find it very hard to be a bear or form any kind of a bearish argument in this zone. If you had any kind of bearish argument, it would have been before Bitcoin broke one of its major resistance levels, really its last major resistance level, keeping it in a downtrend, which was $46,000. And the fact that we're having consistent and strong candle body closings above this point is a pretty positive note for me. Now, going back to what's happening in the news over here, let's talk about some positive sentiment. I know a lot of people have been asking about ApeCoin, and ApeCoin is now going to be able to be staked to earn a yield on Nexo. So Nexo is going to be allowing investors to earn yields on their Bored Ape inspired token. So ApeCoin will now earn roughly a 12% annual yield just by staking it on Nexo. And I think what this will do is actually be an opportunity for other similar platforms. Maybe Celo or other platforms will follow. And I think other platforms are going to start allowing ApeCoin staking, because now that Nexo has set the standard, competitors have to follow in some way, shape, or fashion. Otherwise, Nexo just gets more market dominance. Now, on top of all this, perhaps some of the biggest news, this one is a couple of days old, but Exxon is now mining Bitcoin in North Dakota as part of a plan to slash its emissions. And this is big because they were talking about not just maybe starting 10 or 100 or a couple hundred miners. They're saying that they plan to start out with thousands of miners. Again, not hundreds, but they are shipping containers full of thousands, as we can see right here, of Bitcoin miners. They're expected to launch, or it talks about their launch date and everything else, but this is big, because what they're essentially doing is natural gas that would have otherwise been burned, and talks about it right here. Essentially, they're going to be diverting natural gas that would have otherwise been burned off in the generators, which convert the gas into electricity used to power these Bitcoin miners. And again, it's going to be thousands of them. Now, it makes you wonder, have they been doing this for a while now? And who was the person that had the bright idea that said, if we are burning all of this gas, why not convert it into electricity and power all these Bitcoin miners? I would imagine they're getting a raise right now, because this is going to generate quite a bit of revenue for Exxon. Now, I understand that they are just a massive company, one of the largest oil companies in the world. So this isn't going to be their new primary income by any means, but if they have thousands and thousands of Bitcoin miners going, I mean, they're going to be gaining a significant amount of Bitcoin every single day, every single week, every single month. And it looks like that they're so bullish on this that they're not only just stopping there, but they already have plans to potentially expand into Alaska, Nigeria, Argentina, I believe this is pronounced Guyana, and even in Germany. So they already have plans to expand all over the place. We're talking South America, North America, Europe, Africa, you name it. They want to expand all over the entire world with their Bitcoin mining operations. So that is crazy that we've reached this point in cryptocurrency where even major oil companies are getting in and saying that this is something that they're going to participate in. And it seems like it really is a win-win, right? I mean, they are going to be cutting their emissions and not wasting natural gas at the same time, while also making a much more crypto-friendly world. Now, as we continue over here, money is just pouring into GameFi. Any of you guys that are part of the channel or know me on a somewhat deep level know that I love GameFi. I love GameFi, I love Metaverse, I love play to earn, whatever you want to call it. I love this space. It's something that I'm very bullish on. I think it's extremely undervalued. And to put it in perspective, esports, which is the essentially competitive gaming, has more views than every single sport in the United States, with the exception of the NFL, which means that gaming in the US is generating more views from their competitive tournaments than the NBA, NHL, MLB, MLS, whatever you want to call it. They are receiving more views than every major American sport, with the exception of football. They are a a ridiculously large industry for this. But the space continues to grow, and I think that GameFi has such a bright future as it takes something that so many gamers are familiar with and just makes it better. And it also offers a way for not only gamers to get in, but also people who want to invest. It really is the best of both worlds. So GameFi continues to just grow. I think DeFi is going to play a big part in that as well. I love DeFi equally as much. But there's just a lot happening across the board of cryptocurrency. And finally, what we have over here is the Luna Guard Foundation, otherwise known as the LFG, continues to build their reserve. And so if you guys don't know what I'm talking about here, Luna is trying to get a $10 billion worth of Bitcoin to back and act as a reserve for their stablecoin UST in case of numerous events that could happen or that will happen. I believe right now they're at around 3 billion or they're trying to push towards 3 billion. But if they actually get to a $10 billion reserve, Luna will be the single largest Bitcoin holder outside of Satoshi Nakamoto. So this is crazy. They're right up there right now with Michael Saylor and a few others, but there's not very many people who have $3 or even $10 billion worth of Bitcoin. I mean, that really truly is a lot of money, and that would put them at the largest Bitcoin holder outside of Satoshi Nakamoto. So Terra has some big, big plans. It doesn't look like they want to stop buying Bitcoin anytime soon. One of their founders, Do Kwon, has been talking about how he continues to plan to just actively buy up Bitcoin so long as he is able to. And they received a lot of funding. So I really don't see the buying stopping anytime soon from Terra. It looks like they're bullish on crypto, and it looks like just about everyone else is as well. If we look at the altcoin chart, altcoins, of course, have broken out. We talked about this massive squeeze on the altcoin chart. If you want to check out exactly what we were talking about, just look at the previous videos. I mean, this was nothing new to us. Altcoins are breaking out. It looks like we want to reverse to a golden cross on this daily chart as well. Altcoins are seeing a lot of strength. I see them having resistance next, around $1.28 trillion in market cap, as mainly just because this was a previous bottom turned into a local top right here. We can see this very clearly. We bottomed out here, retested as resistance, so I would imagine that it will continue to be resistance as we approach this. But after this, I mean, next real resistance level is going to be all the way up at around 1.39 to 1.38 trillion. So just a little bit of room to run over here in altcoins, and we could even have even more of an altcoin season to come, because the entirety of the altcoin market right now is down about 40% from their all-time highs right now. So still a lot of potential for altcoins. Keep your eyes out on the ones that haven't moved yet. I was going to say Solana was one of them, but Solana is now, as we speak, moving pretty rapidly to the upside as they're up almost 11.5% on the day. They were one of the ones that had not moved yet. So look at the weekly, look at the monthly, and see maybe which coins are behind. Make sure it's a strong fundamental project, but there definitely is opportunity still out there in the markets. And I hope everyone is staying safe. You know, this is a good time to be in crypto for the most part. So long as you're outside of the Axie or Ronin situation, it really does seem like most cryptos are doing good. I mean, Zilliqa, wow, I didn't even realize this one, up nearly 50% on the day. So it's a great time to be into cryptocurrency. Hopefully everyone was able to in some form or fashion buy the dip and make some sort of profit off of this. But if you did not, I'm sure there will be plenty of more potential lying ahead over here. So that's going to go ahead and round us up for this video, everyone. If you did enjoy this, make sure you hit that like button, hit that subscribe button, and stick around, because again, we have more content coming out like this one every single week. We usually make around 2 to 3 videos a week over here and try to get those up on Wednesdays, Thursdays, and Fridays. Always Wednesdays and Fridays. Sometimes we get a Thursday upload in there as well. But there's a lot happening, so make sure you stay informed in the world of crypto or tune into the channel so that you don't have to do all the research and I can hopefully get all that educational news and feed it right to you without you having to spend all the time and do it yourself. So anyway, guys, that's going to be it. That's going to wrap us up. I hope you all did enjoy, and I will see you all very, very soon.